Welcome back to World Sport here at Britain's Open Golf Championship at Muirfield on the eve of the tournament. And it's not much fun being an Aussie in the UK right now after success for the Lions down under and for England in the first Ashes test. Adam Scott admitted as much, but the banter will cease if he lifts the claret jug here. He threw away a four-stroke lead over the last four holes 12 months ago, an experience he says made him stronger.
You just have to be tough coming down the stretch, and I wasn't tough enough that day. A four-shot lead isn't enough, you know, if you're not going to be tough. Even if you're being tough, four shots can not be, you know, can only just get you over the line.
Adam Scott's Masters win was his first in a major, and the same thing happened to Justin Rose at the US Open. So who's next to become a first-time major champion? Perhaps Luke Donald.
Just looking at Justin, just looking at Adam, you know, they've had some similar career paths up until they won a major to myself, I think. Having won a World Golf Championship, some tournaments, big tournaments around the world, but not having quite broken through. I feel like, you know, hopefully my turn's coming.
Of course, you can't discount Ernie Els, the double defending champion, because not only did he lift the title 12 months ago, but he won the Open when it was last here at Muirfield in 2002.
Obviously, honoured to be in that position, to be defending champion here at Muirfield, you know, winning in 2002 and, you know, coming back since then for the first time. It's just a great feeling. I don't know, you know, it's in my career, it's one of the more special things that I've ever been involved with.
And you're a course designer yourself, of course. What do you make of the little tweaks they've had to Muirfield since 2002?
Well, I think they're all good. You know, I think they haven't changed the angles. You know, the angle's very similar. They just, with the length, they're putting the bunkers back into play. Because technology's changed again in the last 10 years, you know, 2002 to today, guys are hitting the ball a little further. So they had to make those changes, and they've made them on key holes, like on 18, 15, 14, number 9, number 4 even, the par 3. So some really significant changes, but they had to be done.
You certainly can't rule out the defending champion Ernie Els this year. Shane O'Donoghue, host of our Living Golf Show, is with me. But you also can't rule out, Shane, someone who hasn't won a major before, because we've seen it happen to Adam Scott and Justin Rose already this year.
Yeah, and it's been a fantastic year as well, and they are two great gentlemen. So I hope that trend continues. I'd like to see a fresh winner. I'd like to see a new winner. But the thing about Muirfield is that it always throws up a class champion.
It sounds like you're pushing us towards a Tiger Woods or a famous name. But Peter Dawson, the head of the R&A, said this course is in better condition than any since he joined the organisation in 2000. Does that open up the field then?
Do you know something? I don't think it does. And it's interesting, I spoke to Martin Keimer this morning, and Martin has been a guest of ours on Living Golf several times, and he was saying that what he likes about this course is it's so straightforward. In actual fact, you don't have to spend too long trying to figure it out. It's all there in front of you. But sometimes you can be lulled into a false sense of security. And the thing about this course is this, look at this, Alex. This rough is just penal. You go in here, it's cabbage. You've got to just try and knock it out with a wedge. It's like the US Open, but this is even worse. The length of this is very severe. If you're not going to drive it straight, you're not going to win the Open.
Shane's excited, so am I. The guessing game is almost over. Back to you in the studio.